I'm coming to get you, girl. That's right, it's on the night. You're just my type, you're what I like. I bring that heat, you heard me right. Everywhere I go, go, let's go. Some news, another episode. Music bumping, sweat dripping on the dance floor. I like it when shorty get the back in the bag. When she do it like that, I don't know how to act. Now work it, boy, grind it on me, that's perfect. I pay to play if it's worth it. My phone when you want me, you can chirp it. You get to work it.
Let me take these bricks and break them down. If you want, I can serve them by the pound. Shawty know she got what I wanna flip. Baby girl, tell me you can handle it.
Well, if you want it, let's go. I got that fire.
So hot, I'll burn it down.
Act like you already know. I got that fire.
Cause I'm the flyest chick around.
I burn it down on stage, I make it hot. Till the fire marshals come shut down the spot. I had a quartet pack every time I rock. These other niggas ain't got the style I got. I go back to the basics and break it all the way down. You can hate this, but face it, B.I.G. and Tupac just ain't around. Everywhere you go, there I go, I'm 50 Cent. Get on star by the bar, I get you bent. You want party, let's party. You want freak, be a freak. You want creep, we creep. Tell me what you need so you can
take these bricks and break them down. If you want, I can serve them by the pound. Shawty know she got what I wanna flip. Baby girl, tell me you can handle it.
Well, if you want it, let's go. I got that fire.
So hot, I'll burn it down.
Like I already know. I got that fire.
Cause I'm the flyest chick around.
Ready, I said, are you really ready? I make the temperature rise now, don't be surprised. I had ice on stuntin' heavy. I got a hell of a flow, you sure already know. Sold over 30 million records already. It's the third time around, you know how I get down. I'm here down pound for pound.
Greetings, brothers and sisters. Greetings, melanated world. Greetings to all the people, all the brothers and sisters in the Americas, North America, Central America, South America, and also abroad. Greetings from Mother Africa, from the throne where we rule from. Greetings from our brothers and sisters over in the UK, over in Ireland, over in Spain, over in Italy, all through Western, Eastern Europe, and throughout Australia, and everywhere else. And once again, welcome to the amazing show. I'm your host, your humble servant, the one and only, the Black Knight himself, the Moorish Knight himself, Mr. O. And before I get started, we know Thursdays, I have that fire as well. That's the song. You see, you heard. But let me go ahead. I want to give a shout out and pay honors and a happy, although he's not with us anymore, but he is with us in the afterlife. A happy born day, happy solar returns to one of the master teachers and one of the people I admire listening to and still listen to his teachings to this day. Happy birthday to Dr. Khalid Abdul Muhammad. Yes. And on top of that, Khalid Muhammad, yeah, he is more Islam. You know, so pay honors to that, you know, to Dr. Khalid, man. I mean, man was a true Capricorn right there to the end. Very stern on what he stood on when he stood on this square. He didn't waver or nothing. That's the beauty about when you got people in your ranks, in your circle, that's Capricorns. You know, they're very stern individuals. So I get along good with Capricorns. I'm a Scorpio, so we very strong-willed and very disciplined. All right, now we got that out the way. Welcome to another episode of Coon Hunters Thursdays. I got the Remington 870 right here. Got a brand new scope on it. And no, I'm not Ryan Felipe from Shooter. But I'm better at it. January has been a very interesting month. These past few days, I mean, excluding the fact that, you know, January 8th was Founders Day, you know, Happy Born Day. Honors go to the Prophet Noble Drew Ali. But the thing is, what's been going on in current events and stuff like that have you been seeing, whether you, a lot of y'all listen to, I know y'all sports fanatics, or whether y'all follow these TV reality shows and all this other stuff like that. And no, I'm not finna, you know, it's been like an influx, and even on social media, it's been like an influx of cooning, bedwenching, tap dancing, buck dancing, going on right now, you know, or as in Khalid Muhammad would say, you know, you got a bunch of our people out there that's bunching some old sissified, cowified, homogenized, buck dancing, boot licking, tap dancing, saying punkified, sissified, niggified, homogenized, quote unquote house nigga, or bedwench or whatever like that, or Sambo. And a lot of this has been going on, particularly, like, not just in the real world, but also on social media, and particularly on the YouTube platform as well. And it really kind of, like, really, it's really bothersome, and it's really disturbing. You know. Now, I know a lot of people probably wanted me to do my intake, and I've been promised y'all about what I said I was going to do, my thoughts on the Umar Johnson and Cyrus Sutton City situation. And I'm going to humbly apologize on that. And, you know, like I said, the more I think about it or anything like that, I say, no, I'm not even going to go ahead and do a podcast on that, because it's not even worth wasting the time. But I did mention about it though. On grown man talk with my good friend and buddy Irvin V. Griffin Jr. You know, you could go to his YouTube channel and look for the grown man talk me and him had live on there, and I brought that up. So that's about as close as you gonna have me to say about Umar Seti with that WWE WWF promo skit that they did. Moving right along, but I'm not straying too far away from the so-called conscious community or whatever like that, because it is one individual I'm definitely going to call out. Now, no, I'm not going to talk about, my apologies. And no, I'm not going to go ahead and call out brother not so polite, forget him. I been said he was a fraud a long time ago, but I'm really looking at the puppet master behind a lot of this crap, and he's been doing it for the past several years. And I'm calling out, yeah, Frank Gehry, otherwise known to y'all as Sonetta, or normally call him Son Nigga. You know, that's more like be like that. Sonetta for years has been, he been hustling, no doubt about that. He is no doubt a master hustler. I will give him that. But, you know, he started out up there in New York, over there on 125th Street in Harlem, when he went up there talking about, you know, selling the doing the bootleg DVDs, selling all the lectures of our great master teachers like Dr. Ben, Dr. Clark, Ashwa Kwesi, Steve Coakley, Khalid Muhammad, and a whole lot of them. And he's made money off of this, especially when it comes down to these debates that they hold and stuff. So I never came to my attention back in 2006, 2007, around that time. And he came to my attention through the clown, Elliot Lloyd, otherwise known as Seti. And you know, he had threw shade at the Moors, no doubt. And you know, he cooning and all that stuff too. So that's the reason why you see in the picture there, if you follow me on YouTube, about with the picture of a whole bunch of raccoons, because there's a lot of them I'm gonna try to get into. I may have to do a second part on this. But as time marched on, Sonetta got schooled by basically one of the master teachers, and which was Taj Tariq Bey, about with the Moors, about nationality, about the term black, why black doesn't identify race nor nationality. But here's the thing about how contradictory this fool is. He knows this. But he still goes out here and be shouting, you know, black power this, black power that, or I'm not an African, I'm not black, or some bullshit like that. And he's done made plenty money off of these brothers. He done made money off Polite. He done made money off of these stupid debates and stuff like that. Because, see, before then, when he was selling the bootlegs on the corners right there, he was driving some type of hoopty. Now look what the hell he's pushing. And I'm not knocking nobody from upgrading to a new whip or nothing like that. You know, yeah, pursue the American dream, that's you, blah, blah, blah. But if you're supposed to be the type of cat that's supposed to be, quote, unquote, banging on that beast or bang against the cracker, then what the fuck you doing driving around in an $80,000 2014 Mercedes S500 Nazi sled? You know, to my people, I mean, if y'all want to go ahead and go to these debates and all that, you know, I can't tell you what to do. That's on you. But don't fall for the okie doke, because, like, Sonetta don't love his people, man. He never loved his people. Never had, never will. That's why, I, you know, me personally, my personal reservations I have for him is just that. It's just going to be personal reservations, because I have a total disdain for a clown like that. You know, who uses this to try to go ahead and exploit his own people just for his benefit. Now, that's the worst type of coonery I've ever seen in my life. But slowly but surely, you know, we're living in the age of Aquarius. And it's guys like that, they being exposed anyway. The age of illusion is over. The jig is up. Same thing go for brother, for Polite. You know, I listen to some of his BS as well. But he's a clown, though. You know what I'm saying? He's a clown. You know, he got little lessons and all that. He got him a little following. But what's the next thing he do? You know, he go takes his ass over there to L.A. and stuff. You know, I listened to a video where he talked about saying how he was going to rail against the cracker and all that. But yet, though, he's over in L.A. being all, you know, hugged up on K-Beckys and stuff. So what kind of BS is that? And don't even get me started with the little staged arrest and assault by the LAPD. I mean, the Lower Alabama Police Department. You know, Polite, you ain't fooling nobody, man. It's the same thing with a lot of those other cats, you know. But, yeah, you put that crap on social media, get a little following, get a little money to set up that little PayPal or GoFundMe thing. People, y'all got to be careful with shysters like this. And they coons, too. They're the worst kind of coons and Sambos you ever could see. Speaking of which, I mean, there's so many for me to cover in this short amount of time and stuff like that. I do want to call out, like, I'm calling out, like, one individual and stuff like that. Now, anybody know I'm cool with Cynthia G. I'm cool with a lot of the few other sisters that be on YouTube, that, you know, that be on social media using their platform, like myself, to go ahead and, you know, and get this information and knowledge and, you know, warning letters and stuff like that to show you what you need, what needs to be done, to educate you what need to be done. And that way we can rise together and be better than the people. You know, I believe the ancestors would agree with that. The forefathers would agree with that. Don't be like them. Be better than them. Without giving in or succumbing to Caucasian supremacy. But lately, it's been a lot of coons that's been coming on YouTube, too, using their platform for bullshit. Do not even get me started with that other guy. Irv, if you're listening, I know who you're talking about. He ain't even worth mentioning. it's two individuals that basically kind of rubbed me the wrong way a lot. You know, Jada Black is one. And then this other one here that looked like he ought to be auditioning for another remake of Mighty Joe Young. That's O'Shea Dookie Love Jackson. And that kind of makes me even more mad because he got my last name, you know. Him right along with another idiot by the name of One Real Angry MF. That's another clown too, you know. These are the worst type of coons I've ever seen in my life. You know, they get out here, you know, they are coons. They're straight coons. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. No other two ways you can look at it. Especially O'Shea. You know, how he goes ahead and wails in on and rails against Cynthia G, calling her, you know, saying her weave is fake, this and that and all that. You know, he's already disrespecting sisters, disrespecting black women as it is now. And then gonna turn around here and want to put the European women up here on a pedestal. You know, I really, really hate these guys for that. You know, trust me, if this was in the real world and this was on the block, he'd be the type I'd walk up to him and I just straight pistol whip him. That's what I meant. Because see, as long as there's air breathing in my lungs and there's blood flowing through my veins like that, I'm not finna sit by and I ain't trying to play no captain save 'em all or nothing like that. I'm just a brother and stuff who like this. You're not finna calling these coons out and you're not finna go ahead and disrespect the sisters. You know, some of them are comfortable with that Stockholm syndrome. I'm not talking about them. This ain't got shit to do with them. But you look at most of his videos, it's always all about he bashing black women. I mean, that's a waste of freaking bandwidth. That's a waste of time, a waste of space, a waste of megabytes. When he could be trying to use it for something, because from what I see, he's got a heck of a following. But he could be trying to use that for something greater. I just don't get these guys. I really don't. But in my book, he's a fuckboy. I'm just going to call it like I see it. He's a fuckboy. Same thing with the other two clowns. You know, see, when cats do stuff like this, that means something must have happened to them in their previous life. Or somebody done broke their heart or hurt them in a way that they don't see no other way to recover. Which is the biggest bunch of caca I've ever heard in my life. I mean, look, man. Everybody here is adults. We've all, one time in our life, whether through our adolescent years, late adolescent to early young adult years, we've all been hurt by somebody that we was into, we invested, that we cared about. But you have to understand why you own this plane. That everything you do when you wake up in the morning, it's a test. Okay? This system is designed to test you and to see how you will respond. Now, you could go ahead and respond violently, but what would the outcome be of that? Besides you going ahead being arrested, have a number waiting for you, jumpsuit, so on so. Too many of our brothers done got caught, brothers and sisters are caught up into that. Or you could go ahead and do like what President Obama often do, how he's been ridiculed the past 8 years, two terms he was in office. Take the high road. But like I say, I digress. But the thing is, with these coons, and I said this all the time, and I'm going to reiterate what Willie D said. If your criticism of the black community outweighs your contributions, you're a coon. Plain and simple. And this motherfucker ain't never contributed nothing. You know, Yeah, you real bold going here like this. And I don't blame Cynthia. You know, kudos for her for being the stand-up sister that she is. Say, don't even waste your time even arguing with these fools. Just like I shouldn't even waste my time even mentioning this fool here on my channel. But it has to be said. It has to be said. O'Shea Dookie Love Jackson is a fuckboy. And them other two clowns, Jada Black and one real angry MF, they fuckboys. Plain and simple. But they coons. Along, they no worse than Sarnetta. They straight coons, man. And on top of that, on worse, it make real brothers out here look bad. We got bigger issues to go ahead to deal with, okay? We got bigger issues to more deal with. We about trying to focus on trying to build trade and commerce, and go ahead and build our own economic powerhouse. You know, and they always gonna sit and see a lot of the times, a lot of these guys sometimes they age of provocateurs. I'm not surprised about that with Sarnetta. I've said that for years. And I believe that in my heart, that he's an agent provocateur. And because you see the whole conscious community, they've been thoroughly infiltrated. They went thoroughly infiltrated. Now look at Sarnetta's next hustle. Look at what he's doing right now. I posted it like on my Facebook page. You know, or should I say Facebook? Because I really don't fuck that shit no more. You know, I posted that shit up on Facebook because, you know, a lot of people know I do most of my stuff over on Blaqspot, which is popping right now. You know, Sarnetta now, he rubbing elbows now with Tariq Nasheed. And this ain't no shot at, I ain't trying to throw shade at Tariq and all that stuff, but Tariq, watch yourself, man. That's all I got to say. You know what I'm saying? Ain't really much for me to go on with a lot of these coons and these old Sambos here. Ain't really much for me to even go on them about, because they clowns, man. They all clowns. But you know, but they day of reckoning come. And I just saw a video with let me address O'Shea again, how he came out and he disrespected the elder, Rashawn DeLay. Shout out to the elder Rashawn DeLay. But that's all right. Rashawn DeLay got in his ass though. You know? But, you know, these guys, they soft, they weak. Sisters, these the type of brothers y'all need to try to avoid. Because, see, trust me, because when the deal goes down, they're going to tuck their tail between their legs and run the other way. Hell, I got more respect for a hyena than them. At least a hyena would stand and fight. They more cowardly than they are. But, you know, they getting exposed one day at a time as well, you know. You think Dr. Khalid would have, if he was still alive, man, he'd have come out here eating these suckers, man. He'd eating them. As you can hear, that's another notification I'm getting from Blaqspot. As I say, it's popping. It's popping. Excuse me. It's popping. But like I said, I really ain't got much to say on these guys. Because I don't want to give them a much bigger platform that they don't already need. So, with that said, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to sign out on this. First thing, you know, happy birthday to Dr. Khalid Muhammad. And I ain't doing that on Cool on this Thursday, but it's got to be said, January 12th is a special day. Happy birthday to Dr. Khalid Muhammad. Shout out to Cynthia G. Shout out to Phil from the Advise Show. Oh, shout out to Daryl, CEO, owner of Blaqspot. Shout out to the Blaqspot. That's where it's popping. That's where it's at. All people in Melanoid Nation, man, they need to come on over there. Do that. It's 5,000 strong and over 5,000 strong and climbing and stuff. So, you know, get up off that Facebook plantation and stuff. Also, check out Black Junction. That's another social networking platform. And another one that I came across, Our time is now. That's H-O-U-R, time is now. Check them out, too. You know. So, with that said, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to cut this short for Coon Hunters Thursday. If you're watching this via YouTube, you can always leave your comments down in the comment section. And if you want to subscribe, feel free. Have at it. You can check me out over on Twitter, which is my Twitter handle, AmonRa7. That's Amon_Ra_7. I know the trolls are listening and all this stuff like that. But don't worry. Security protocols already in place to block y'all dumbasses. So I'm not even worried about y'all. So with that said, that could, this is going to conclude another episode of Coon Hunters Thursday. I'm your host once again, the Moorish Knight himself, Mr. O, the AKA the Black Knight to all my other ones. With that said, I'm out. James, let's go. We got to take care of the sponsors. Let's roll. This is Mr. O here, the host of The Amazing Show. If you like what you heard today on my podcast episode, you can always download the app Spreaker from either Android or iOS. Look for the yellow star that says Spreaker Podcast Radio, and you can subscribe right there to my channel. Also, I broadcast live via YouTube, Twitter, Facebook, Tumblr, and SoundCloud. And as always, all my episodes are downloadable on and offline. Plus, you can also check me out over on Blaqspot. That's where it's popping. That's where it's happening at. You can come through right there. It's a social networking site that's for us as a people. For us, by us. Without any album, without any pink interference. With that said, I'm out.